guys, it's Kim JongLi, and this time I'm going to show you a battle I had against a Greek corner camper. His name at the time was Matheus, Marques. Anyway, I brought Spain, which in one of my previous videos I said was a really good matchup for Greece because it pretty much guaranteed you a heroic victory. Basically, in this game, I made a ton of errors. I mismicroed my cav and my infantry, so my infantry got caught here, I wasted some cav here as well, and I wasted a ton of cav over here, so this is like 3 units and I wasted like 2 units here. So in the end, right now I've only got 2 cav units left. I've got my general and like this round shield cav unit with 5 men in it. Basically right now my whole army is Valeric slingers and normal slingers, and I've got a unit of bull warriors, and that's all that's left of my infantry. So my enemy has 9 Spartans left. He started off with 15 Spartans and 15 Cretan archers. I killed the Cretan archers with my cav, and most of the some of the Spartans have been killed by my slingers or cav units. So he's only got these 9 Spartans left, and right now he's running to the corner, and he's decided to corner camp. So I'm just walking my warriors because I don't want them to get tired. My slingers are exhausted from all the running. So yeah, very tired. Fast forwarded a bit. So I see he's corner camped, and the advantage of corner camping, obviously, against a skirmish army is that I can't get into the back of him and shoot his back. So I can only shoot his front, because that's the only angle available to me. But as I moved closer, he like shrank even more, and it was still corner camping, but basically he opened up this kind of flank to me because I moved really close with my slingers just so I would be able to get more accurate shots on him so more rocks would hit his guys. And I'm basically using these 2 slingers to sling the side of these guys and using these slingers to sling the side of these guys. And so you'll see these guys on my left, they'll drop really quickly. So fast forward. So yeah, they get shredded. And right now he breaks the corner camp and starts running after my Valeric slingers. This unit of Valeric slingers has run out of ammo, so it's just an infantry unit now. And I've got this unit of bull warriors here. As you can see, one of my slingers did get caught, unfortunately. But yep, this body of infantry was my goal. So I've got bull warriors and slingers here. I'm going to engage this blob with my bull warriors, sling them in the back with these slingers, and then engage them on the flank with these Valeric slingers while positioning my cav, and then I'm going to go for a back cav strike, hammer and anvil, straight into the back of this mass. This is 5 units of depleted Spartans. So if I get rid of this, he's pretty much only got these 2 units left, and this is basically not even 10 men. So as you can see, I've engaged him on the sides, slinging him in the back, and my general's cav unit pretty much did the rest of the work. That was a long shield cav unit, by the way. And he's only got this one unit of 7 men left, and 2 units of 5 and 4 men left. And that's pretty much the game. So that was a heroic victory. I expect my long shield cap got a ton of kills. That was from slingers. Round shield cap didn't get as much. I didn't use them as well. My slingers got pretty decent kills considering they were shooting at Spartans the whole time, as did these Balearic Slingers. My Bull Warriors and Scutarii were used really badly, so I kind of wasted money on them. But as you can see, it's really easy to beat Greece with Spain. This is probably the easiest heroic victory matchup you can get in a low Denarii game. Anyway, thanks for watching.